each of you. I believe the Holy Spirit brings everybody together when it comes to worship, and so I invite you all to rise as we sing our gathering hymn. Holy God, holy and mercy, holy and mighty.
You are the river of life. You are the everlasting wellspring.
In mercy and might, you have freed us from death and raised us with Jesus, the firstborn of the dead.
In the baptismal waters, our old life is washed away, and in them we are born anew.
Glory to you, for oceans and lakes, for rivers and streams. Praise to you for the life-giving waters of baptism, the outpouring of the Spirit of the new creation.
Wash away our sins and all that separate
satisfy the world's need through this living water. Where drought dries, the earth bring refreshment. We ask this through Christ, who with you and the Spirit reigns forever.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
the Holy Spirit, Stephen gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. Look, he said, I see the heavens open, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. But they covered their ears, and with a loud shout, all rushed together against him. Then they dragged him out of the city and began to stone him. And the witnesses laid their coats at the feet of a young man named Saul. While they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. Then he knelt down and he cried out in a loud voice, Lord, do not hold this sin against them. Then he, after he had said this, he died. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 31, let's read it together on page 6. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness. Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe, for you are my crag and my stronghold. For the sake of your name, lead me and guide me. And to your hands I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me, O Lord, God of truth. Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your steadfast love. The second reading is from 1 Peter. Like newborn infants, long for the pure spiritual milk, so that by it you may grow into salvation, if indeed you have tasted that the Lord is good. Come to him, a living stone, though rejected by mortals, yet chosen and precious in God's sight. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house to be the holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, see, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone chosen and precious, and whoever believes in him will not be put to shame. To you then who believe, he is precious. But for those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner, and a stone that makes them stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the word, as they were destined to do. But you who are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into the marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the except through me. If you know me, you know the Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly, I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it." The Gospel of the Lord. Dear siblings in Christ, grace to you and peace from our heavenly parent, from Jesus the Son, and from the Spirit of God. Amen. It is so good to see you all, so good to hear you all singing, and especially good to see those of you who were participating in Elijah last night. A lot of our student singers, and Bob, Carol, Vera, anybody else? Judy, of course. She's standing right behind me. Singing their praises in a mass chorus with orchestra. And I need to say this because when we celebrate Holy Communion, right before we all sing the Holy, 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 there's a leading line up to that. And it will start maybe with some individual names, but then it will say, "And with the angels and archangels and the whole host of heaven, we join the unending hymn." And you know, I don't know how many singers there were last night. About 120 singers, yeah, and full orchestra. That's about as full of a chorus as I can imagine. So, if you picture the angels and archangels and whole host of heaven, by the way, that's in our window back there. Take some time to look at it. It's Jesus seated in the center window, on the throne of God. And there are four angels at the bottom, holding banners that say Sanctus, which is Latin for holy. So it gives the feeling of the angels singing holy, holy, holy to each other right in the stained glass window. The window is a very act of worship. That's why Amber pulls out all the stops. She's got to accompany a lot of voices. This is what Stephen saw as he was about to be martyred. He looked heavenward and he saw a vision of Jesus in his glory. And he did not fear his martyrdom. Martyrdom, by the way, is, we know it as the murder of one of the the saints. But the word martyr simply means witness. Stephen's crime, the reason he was stoned to death, was because he was a witness to the good news of Jesus. That doesn't make sense, does it? But only if you're thinking of pedestrian, watered down Jesus. Jesus was far from that. Jesus proclaimed love and forgiveness and healing and welcome to everyone. Jesus was not just of the lineage of David. Jesus came for every tribe and every nation. And that got him crucified. As it got Stephen stoned. It's a subversive message when we want to hold on to our own tribe. This gospel reading from John chapter 14. We've got a couple of retired pastors in the group and lots of church musicians. And we've heard this gospel reading. We've preached this gospel reading a lot of times at a funeral. It's a word of hope that in God's house, God's dwelling, God's mansion, there's room for everybody. And when we're grieving, we take special consolation, solace, in the fact that there's room for my loved one that's not here anymore, because we miss them dearly, and we hope that someone still loves them. Someone is still taking care of them. And that is our Christian hope. In my Father's house, or my Father's mansion, there are many rooms. There's room for everybody. But Stephen's martyrdom, because of his witness of Jesus, the writer of Acts was very specific in pointing out Stephen died very much like Jesus died. Violently. Terribly. We were talking with our staff meeting what it must be like to be stoned to death. But in his demeanor, we get a glimpse of what it is to be close to Jesus, for being a witness to the good news. And the good news is Jesus came to show us who God was. John 14. Philip couldn't figure out how to see the Father. And dear Thomas, who, if you remember, the Sunday after Easter, every single Sunday after Easter, we bash on Thomas because he was doubting Thomas. So I won't believe that you're the risen Christ. until I see your wounds. Well, John 14, of course, is before the crucifixion, before the resurrection. And dear Thomas says, Lord, we don't even know where you're going. How can we know the way? They've been following Jesus for a while. And I can picture that Jesus was, I don't know, frustrated, maybe sad. We don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? Jesus said, am the way. I am the way. Self-sacrificing, loving, healing, lifting up foreigners, touching lepers. I am the way. If you've seen me, you've seen the Father. John 14 was very close to the crucifixion. Jesus didn't have much time to get his message into those who followed him most closely. This is why he wept over Jerusalem. Jesus came to proclaim the way of God, which is love and mercy. And the world wouldn't have any of it. Even a lot of people who thought they were doing God a favor by crucifying Jesus, by stoning Stephen, did it because they thought they were doing God a favor. Dear friends in Christ, that's not the way of Jesus. Jesus, who said, I am the way and the truth and the life. In Jesus, we find the truth. And the life. The Gospel of John has all of these wonderful I am sayings. I am the light. I am the bread of life. I am, I am. This goes all the way back to the book of Exodus when Moses asked God, you know, the people are asking for a name. What shall we call you? And still in Jewish custom, you don't say the name of the Lord out loud. So God said, my name is I am. You want to fill in a word at the end, don't you? Subject, verb, matching. But no. Is pure verb. God is in everything around us, in everyone around us. The powers of this world are nails and stones. Guns and bombs. The way of Jesus is love, compassion, mercy. I know it's hard, you know, when somebody takes takes a swipe at you, you want to take a swipe back. I get it. But that's the world calling you to that way. You, my beloved, are a royal priesthood. Emissaries of the living God. This was such a beautiful, beautiful word from 2 Peter. You are a chosen race. This is not about race. A royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. What do you do when you've received mercy? The peace of God that passes all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
United in the hope and joy of the resurrection, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. God of life, strengthen your church to proclaim your gospel, even in times of trouble. As we remember Stephen, We give thanks for diaconical ministry. Bless all deacons and strengthen them for their bridge building ministry between church and world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Creating God, you showed your steadfast love through mighty waters, towering mountains, verdant fields, and arid deserts. Protect the earth's diverse habitats from the forces of pollution, erosion, extinction, and global warming. Hear us, O God. Mighty God, your Spirit guides us in all truth. Give wisdom to world and local leaders and organizations as they begin, build, or renew relationships. Strengthen leaders and aid organizations in areas needing to be rebuilt following conflict, unrest, or natural disaster. Hear us, O God. Loving God, you make your home among us. Abide with refugees, those experiencing homelessness, those fleeing war and poverty, and all who question if there is a home in your heart. We pray for all who are sick. Hear us, O God. Assuring God, you accompany your people amid uncertainty and change. Uphold people in this community who have recently moved, changed jobs or schools, retired, or are going through transitions of any kind. Lead us in your ways. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Renewing God, you gather the saints at your heavenly banquet. We give you thanks for the care shown to us by those who have gone before us, especially David and Estranger. Grant confidence and comfort for all awaiting the place you have prepared. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great. Rejoicing in the victory of Christ's resurrection, we lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
God, in this meal you offer yourself, we give thanks for these gifts of the earth. In the breaking of this bread, reveal to us the risen one. In the pouring of this wine, pour us out in service to the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Gathered together by the Holy Spirit, we pray as Jesus does. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the table of the Lord. Jesus is the host of this meal and welcomes you. And now the holy and precious body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Gracious God, if in you we live and move and have our being. With your word and this meal of grace, you have nourished our life together. Strengthen us to show your love and serve in the world in Jesus' name. Amen. everybody here. The announcements are on page 17 and 18, so I'm just going to highlight a couple. The food pantry is low on funds, so anyone that could help out, that would be appreciated. There is an adult discipleship class today at 10:30, and every Sunday in May. Let's see. Quilt blessings next Sunday. Oh, we need ushers. We survived, but we could use some people. And homemade communion bread. Bakers can sign up in the parish hall.
And we thank Rose for the bread this morning. I was blessed this week to be able to attend an adoption formalization. Lisa Kaur and her partner Edgar have adopted Marissa. So they're not here this morning, but if you get a chance to see them or drop them a card, congratulate them. She's permanently got a home. So please rise for the blessing. The God of all, who raised Jesus from the dead, bless you with the power of the Holy Spirit to live in a new creation. Amen.